Welcome back to my garage. Tonight I'm going to show you how to find the balance factor of your crankshaft. The balance factor is how high a percentage of the reciprocating mass, stuff that goes up and down in your engine, is balanced by the counterweight of your crank. If your bike vibrates bad and you can't find anything wrong with it, could be the balance factor or the wrong balance factor. Typical scenario is that you've added a big bore kit, and with that big bore kit comes a heavier piston. Since the piston is heavier, you have effectively lowered your balance factor. Tools needed. First and foremost, you'll need a balancing stand. You can buy real fancy ones with rollers and all kinds of fancy stuff. I've just made the crudest version of them all. Two pieces of wood with steel bar taped to them. All that's really needed are two frictionless surfaces that your crank can roll freely on. This setup was really meant for just a proof of concept, but as it works, and it works great, I haven't really bothered making a new one. You'll need a scale, accurate scale, bonus points for a cheap eBay one. You'll need to make a hook, which you will hang from the conrod. Use a steel wire or other suitable material, and you'll need lots of different small washers and nuts and bearings and stuff you can use as weights, because you are going to hang them from the conrod. Something to write on. Start by weighing the small end of the conrod. We will estimate this to be the reciprocating mass of the conrod. Place the crank beside the scale so that the conrod is level. Put the small end on the scale. An Allen wrench comes in handy for keeping it from rotating. Now weigh the total reciprocating mass, the piston, the small end bearing, the wrist pin, and the circlips, and the conrod. Put the crank in your beautiful stand. Check that it rotates freely. Now hang the hook you've made from wire from the conrod and start adding weight to it. Add weight until it stays put in any position. So that's the goal here. To add enough weight that it won't rotate in any position you put it. You can see that mine does not want to stay in any position yet, so I'll have to add more weight. Now I've gotten it to the point where it stays put in any position. We're done with the balancing part. Place the weight you hung from the conrod on your scale. Remember to include the wire hook. Add conrod weight to hung weight. Now divide the total hung weight with the total reciprocating mass. You've got your balance factor. That's it. It's difficult to say anything about what the right balance factor for you is. There's lots of variables like cylinder orientation, frame geometry, engine mount position and design. Typical values for 45 degree cylinder orientation is about 55%. For horizontal engines, it tends to be a bit lower. For upright engines, it tends to be a bit higher. Trial and error is often needed here. If you changed something and it started vibrating, there should be some clues. Like if you've installed a big bore kit with a heavier piston, then probably you will have to raise the balance factor again. Same goes for the other way around, though most people don't install small bore kits. How to raise or lower your balance factor will be covered in another video. Basically, you'll have to add or remove weight from the crank counterweight. Okay, thanks for watching. Please subscribe and please share this video with your friends if you feel they can benefit from it. See you next time.